In 2016, construction began on a six-story residential development. The adjacent building was a narrow two-story brick commercial and residential property built in 1935 with brick foundations. A principal contractor was engaged for construction management, including demolition and excavation work. The principal contractor engaged a geotechnical engineer to investigate the ground conditions, a structural engineer to develop excavation and foundation plans, and a subcontractor for the eventual excavation. The geotechnical engineer advised the site was feasible, but further investigation was needed once contractors and structural engineers finalized their plans. The structural engineer provided technical drawings and a plan for the construction of piled foundations with a capping beam and shoring walls. The plans noted the adjacent building's foundations should be further verified prior to construction commencing, support mechanisms for those footings should be implemented, and that additional shoring may be required. The plans restricted excavations near the adjacent building's foundations and required the capping beam base not be lower than the adjacent building's foundation. The excavation subcontractor was then instructed to excavate. The neighbouring foundations were not supported, and there was no direct supervision of the excavation works by the principal contractor. While the excavation was being carried out, tenants of the adjacent building noticed constant shaking and items falling off shelves. That afternoon, the excavation work was completed to a depth of 450 millimetres below the level of the proposed capping beam and the adjacent building's foundations. Later that evening, a resident left the building when the walls started to shake. Emergency services were called. On arrival, the eastern wall had partially collapsed. The front of the building had extensive cracks and there was a strong smell of gas. Police established an exclusion zone. By 3 a.m. the next morning, the entire eastern side and front of the building had collapsed. No one was injured. Both the principal contractor and excavation subcontractor failed to determine the size, type, and extent of the adjacent building's foundations, have them verified by a structural and geotechnical engineer, and then ensure the appropriate support. Ensure the adjacent building's foundations were not undermined during excavation, or meet other requirements from the structural engineer. Provide clear instructions and adequate supervision for the excavation work. When excavating, please make sure you consult with experienced and qualified professionals, such as engineers and specialist excavation contractors, prior to commencing work and at critical stages. You consider how the structural integrity of the excavation and any affected structures may be affected by the excavation methods or sequence. All reasonably practicable control measures are considered to manage the risks associated with unplanned structural collapse. You identify and apply the best control measures in consultation with other businesses involved in the work. Workers are competent and receive clear instructions. The work is supervised by a competent person and in accordance with the planned methods and sequence. If issues arise, you stop, take the necessary actions to ensure everyone remains safe, and consult with all relevant persons about how to get back on track. Excavation work can be dangerous. For a copy of the Excavation Code of Practice and other relevant information, please go to our website, safework.nsw.gov.au.